You ever wonder why some hunters move fast? Not because they type faster, not because they have got secret scripts, it's because their setup works with them, not against them. Every click, every request, every node already optimized. While everyone else is opening tools, they already finding bugs. But listen, if you are here for some magic trick that instantly give you bugs or criticals, you are wrong. Finding faster bugs does not come from shortcuts, it comes from experience, muscle memory, and how you use what you already have. And what I'm about to show you right now are not miracle hacks, they are small workflow moves that keep you in flow and cut wasted time. So, this is AmrSec, go get your coffee ready and let's dive in.
Channel has enough content.
Guys, this is about security.
Alright, here is the plan. 3 quick tricks, nothing fancy, no scripts, just pure workflow speed. First, a tiny move inside your proxy that saves you from retyping payloads all day. Second, workflows, the silent assistant that takes over your repetitive tasks while you keep hunting. And third, a small habit that keeps your notes organized, your BOCs clean, and your brain focused on finding the next bug. So, let's get into them one by one. Alright, so let me start with the first trick, but before we do this, I want to show you something. And because today we are going to use Caido, I want to show you Caido Labs. So Caido Labs right here, it's a pretty cool labs that will help you more to understand how to use Caido. It's not about understanding the bug, it's about understanding how you can find the bug with Caido. So here we have different labs, and I can see that 2-minute requests lab is pretty cool, and also the shift payload. So let me just open them with you real quick and show you how this works. So right here is telling you that this lab makes 100 requests to find hidden secret value, and the secret value contains secret value. Okay, so before you show a hint, make sure that your browser is proxied to Caido and start searching. And from here is going to just send a bunch of requests, and you can see that in the HTTP history right here, it will just send 100 requests, and your mission is to find the secret value. Alright, so as you can see, it's telling you that the secret value is found. What you have to do is basically, your mission is just to filter all these requests to get the secret value. And we can do this using HTTPQL really easy by just writing response. And we want all the response to contain this secret value. And you will see 2 requests. First is just the loaded page right here. And the second one is the request that has the secret value. That's pretty much it. It just helps you to understand how to use Caido with powerful way. So this was the first lab, and right here, let me close it. Here we have other lab, which is agent command interface. So it's telling you that this endpoint accepts agent command submission, blah, 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 all of it. What we need to do is right here. This endpoint requires shift plugin. And because we already have this, so I will just create another request to this page, and I will get back to it right here. And here we have it. So I will send it to reply. Right here, I will just click on agents, which is shift agents. You have to have the shift plugin installed. And right here, I will just ask exploit this and create finding once it is success. Okay, so I don't have to explain more, because actually it will send the request, and once he get the response, he will read all of these details, which is just that he have to create a post request and the JSON body. It doesn't know what he have to do, but the JSON error will just guide him through it. Okay, so I will just send this, and right now you will see what's gonna happen. So it started with just sending a normal request and got a response. So it changed the method to post. And as you can see, it's asking that there is missing field, which is agent ID. So he added agent ID, and right here it is invalid. It should start with ID, so he added ID, and right here he added it exactly like what I asked for. And right now we have a new error, which is missing timestamp. So right here he added a timestamp, and it will just continue until the request succeeds. So let me just wait for it. Alright, cool. So I will stop it right now, because he just make it priority 1 and send it, and it was succeed, and he tried to explain it more. That's all we need. Right here you can see that he added agent ID, timestamp, and actions and priority, and the error actually guided him. And right here we can see success and created finding for us right here. So yeah, that's all we need. We don't need anything more. Alright, so that's pretty much it for Caido Labs, and let's dive into our tricks. And the first trick we have is match and replace. Let me just show it to you, okay? So right now, I'm a little bit tired of just writing payloads every day when I try to just find like HTML injection, XSS, blind XSS, or that thing all. So what I did is, right now, let's say that this is our lab, okay? Let me get to the Reflect XS lab, okay? Right here. So let's say that this is our lab. Every time I test an app, I have to write my HTML payload or XSS or even copy it. And it also takes time. So here's what I do. Basically, I just go to my Caido to match and replace. And here I will just add some rules. I give myself before I start like 15 minutes to set up this. So I will just create a new rule, and this rule will be request role. Okay. And it will match any string that have HTMLI, for example. And after this, it will replace it also with a script, which is HTML injection payload, like this, hello italic. Okay, that's pretty much it. You can add different variations, you can add whatever you want, but this is what I do. I call this HTMLI, and I just leave it active in all the session. Nothing will be replaced because nothing just writes this in the request. But right now, when I go right here to the lab and refresh, more than just writing my script, I can just write HTMLI and send it, and you will see right here that it's been replaced in the proxy with my payload, which is hello italic right here. So italic is wrong. So yeah, that's pretty much it. It's just that simple. It just saves more time for me. But hold on, because you have to understand what you are doing right here. This replaces it in the request, but you have to understand that this could just return 400 bad requests because a mistake you do. So for example, let's say that I have added something like this here, okay? And if I try to add HTML right here and send the request, you will see right now that we have syntax error. So it will just return 400 bad requests. So I will just remove this and I handle it by my side. So I can just do this, which will work. I can from here just add this and add HTMLI, and it will just work without any problem. So that's pretty much it for HTMLI. I do it for all the things I have. So let's say I have XSS, okay? So I create a new rule, which is XSS, and you can just create different variants like XSS 1, 2, 3, all the way like what you want. I just create one basically to see if it's gonna reflect, and I will make it string, which is XSS, and here it will be something like SVG, unload, and after this just alert, or maybe just print, okay? And I close it. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Right now, whenever I hear I write XSS and hit enter, it will not do anything because it's not active, so you have to activate it first. We can also do this with a blind XSS. So again, we will make it the request row, and it will match the string, and anything that have blind X word, it will just replace it with, let's say, img unload, let's say onboard, and I will just add my script right here, okay? So onboard this script, okay? And I will just close it and close the tag and update it, and this will be blind X, okay? So yeah, that's how I do it. So right now I don't have to write more payloads. I can just understand what I have. Let's say I'm searching for blind XSS, I will just add blind, and then the proxy will take all the work for me, okay? That's pretty much it. I also do it with the interact sh links. So let's say I have interact sh link I always use in this session, so I can just create the same thing, and right here I will just add host, and I will just add the link for me right here, okay? So yeah, that's pretty much it. I just add a quick mesh and replace rules for myself, so when I just start working, I don't have to go and copy payloads or just write the payloads one more time. I can just add, like, let's say the variables for me to add the payload. And when I switch from a project to project, I don't always just write all of them one more time. I can just download them right here, and you have to make sure that you have even better plugin to do this. And from the other projects, I can also import them. And also you can do another thing, which is dropping this match and replace rule to your account, and just from the other project, you will go to drop and claim it. So it will be on your new project. So yeah, that's pretty much it. That's our first trick. So the second trick we have is workflows. And you may already know this, but I have to mention how I use it to just cut the noise. Let's say that I always send URLs to SQL map, okay? Or whatever XSS tool I use to search for XSS, whatever it is, whatever your Unix tool. So I just try to keep myself always in the keyboard. So what I do is I just go right here in the workflows. I go to active five workflows, I create a new workflow. And this workflow will be something pretty simple. I have a workflow, active start, I will add node. So let's say in the scope, and I will just connect it. And if it's in the scope, I will run a shell. And this shell, let's call this workflow, for example, SQL map. Okay. So right here, if it's in the scope, I will create a shell, and this shell will be right here. Let's make it dash, for example. And right here, I will just make something like SQL map dash u. And here I will just add the Caido URL. And after this dash dash batch or whatever other things you want to add, dash dash banner, for example. And after this, I will just t this in file called output. And after this, what I'm going to do is basically use notify to notify me once it's done. So I will just use notify. And right here, I have first to get the output file. So to notify me with it. So here is, it's just really basic. What you have to do is just you're going to send your request, and once it's being sent, what's gonna happen if it's in the scope, the shell will take it over and use SQL map to start finding SQL injection in a specific parameter. Once it's done, it will just add all the output in file called output, and after this we will just print this file and it will be notified. So it will just send it to me on Discord. So yeah, that's pretty much it. It's just that simple. You don't have to add any other thing. You can just reference right here the request and close it. And after this, the workflow is done. Okay. So if I just save this and try to run it, you will see that it is executed successfully. So this simple workflow will just stop me from going to the terminal every time and copy paste the URLs and do all these things. So how gonna use it? Basically, right now, I will just go to my HTTP history. Let's say this request, I will right click and go to run workflow and SQL map. I don't need anything more. You can also make your own workflows to make things easier. Sometimes we just need to show all the data in the HTTP history, but we just want to know what's in the scope and what's not, because we need to see the other requests, but it's just a little noisy. So we can just create another simple workflow that just colorizes all the in-scope data. So when we just unset the scope, we will see that all our in-scope data, it's just simple tweaks that makes things easier for you. So yeah, that's pretty much it for this one, creating workflows. And if you are not really sure how you can do this, you can go to Caido documentation for the workflows, and it's really simplified there. The next and last trick is the nodes. For me, I usually hunt with 25 5, so I just work 25 minutes and after this take a break for 5 minutes, whether it's coffee or whatever. But here is the thing, I always get distracted with the things I see, because I just let's say I'm working on a specific bug and I can see something that looks really interesting, and it just distracts me because I'm really working on a bug and I have to check this out. So here's what I do, and this would require Node++ plugin if you don't have it. So I always take nodes for anything I need to check out. So let's say I'm working right now in a bug. I saw that this looks interesting. So what I do is send it to reply. And from here, there is a really nice shortcut for Node++ that keeps your hands on the keyboard. Select all of it and Windows Shift N. And right here, we can add something like basically it needs a look. Okay. So once we do this and hit enter, it will just create another node for you with the data. I know that you can mention requests right here, but it's just how you like to do it. Okay, so right here, whatever I see anything, I just take notes, and in my break I get back to this note and see what's actually really interesting. So that's basically it. But you have also to keep your head is just focused on your hand. So if you remember something, when the shift N, write your note, hit enter, and it's there, it's saved. Okay, so you just removed it from your head to keep focused. That's pretty much it. All right, quick recap. 3 modes: match and replace, workflows, and a fast notes habit. They are tiny, but they remove frictions and keep you hunting. Try doing that and you will see. the difference. I know this one was short, just a quick drop to share something that actually helps in real hunting. Remember, speed is not about rushing, it's about removing friction. So take one of these tricks and make it yours and watch how much smoother your workflow gets. And also, if you found this video helpful, do not forget to like, subscribe, and hit that bell icon for more cybersecurity content. And if you have any questions, feel free to drop them in the comments below, or you can reach me directly on Twitter. Until next time, stay curious and stay secure.